kitchen. So guys, today I'm bringing you this awesome recipe of how to make beans or black eyed peas porridge. I know I already have a video on how to do it somewhere up in my channel, but this is an entirely different way of making it, and it is so good that I decided to share with you guys. So guys, if you want to learn how to make black eyed peas or beans porridge my way, then just keep watching. And while you're watching guys, don't forget to give a thumbs up to this video, leave comments in the comment section down below, and subscribe to my channel if you have not done that already. Please do so right now. I love you guys. I'll see you guys in the next video.
So the first thing we'll need will be our beans or black eyed peas, which I had pre-soaked just to save myself some time in the kitchen because I don't have a pressure cooker. So pre-soaking it cuts down the cook time. Then you need some red bell peppers, some onions, scotch bonnet peppers and garlic, sweet corn for some sweetness, spinach, and the last thing you'll need will be your smoked pork hocks. Guys, I'm telling you, this stuff right here, it is flavor town. So now I'm gonna show you a trick, a tip that would save you so much time in the kitchen. So after blending your peppers and your onions and all that stuff, pour it in a strainer and strain it, guys. Strain it. This will cut down your cook time by more than 30 minutes, okay? More than 30 minutes. So just strain it. Now, guys, do not throw away the liquid because that contains so much flavor and all those nutrients from the peppers. So I'm going to go ahead and use that same liquid that I strained out of my peppers to cook my beans, okay? So that way I don't lose that flavor or the nutrients. So now I'm pouring my beans into a pot and I'm pouring my pepper juice or liquid or whatever you call it. Then I'm adding my pork hocks and I'm going to add some salt, some onions, extra water, not too much water, just enough water to cover the surface of the beans, okay? You can always add more water later. So I'm gonna cover this and let it cook for about 30 minutes. 30 minutes is all I need because my beans were pre-soaked, okay? So while my beans are cooking, I'm gonna go ahead and make my pepper sauce. My pepper sauce. So using some oil, I'm gonna just fry this. So guys, here it is. Because I strained out that liquid, it's gonna take me less than 15 minutes. Actually, it took me like 10 minutes to make the sauce. Just 10 minutes. But if I had not strained out that liquid, guys, I would be standing here frying this stuff for about 30 to 45 minutes and nobody got time for that, okay? So in about 10 minutes, my sauce will be perfectly cooked just the way I want it. So I felt like it was a little bit dry, so I added some extra oil and now I've added some sliced onions because guys, when you're cooking beans, onions is the perfect secret ingredient. Just put enough onions, you can never go wrong with onions, okay? So now I'm seasoning my sauce with some seasoning cubes and some salt, and guys, it is literally done. I told you, 10 minutes your sauce is done, okay? So use the tip that I shared with you and strain the liquid. It would save you so much time. So after 30 minutes, my beans is literally done, but it is not too soft because I don't like it too soft. It's al dente just the way I want it because I'm still gonna cook it for an extra 10 minutes, so I don't want it to be too mushy. So now I'm adding my cooked sauce into the pot and I'm gonna stir it really good just to make sure everything is perfectly mixed together. Actually, totally, it took me less than an hour to cook these beans, which is kind of weird because if you know how to make beans and you know it takes so long, but because I pre-soaked my beans, it took a little time. So now I've added some bay leaves and my Tony Chachera's seasoning, which I love. But guys, you can use any kind of seasoning that you love, but I love Tony Chachera's, so that's what I used, and my bay leaves. So now I'm gonna cover this pot and let it simmer for another 10 minutes. So 10 minutes will give time for all the flavors to get married together. So I'm gonna be finishing this up with my sweet corn, which is already cooked. If you were using fresh corn, then you might want to add this earlier in the process to give your corn time to cook, but my corn is already cooked, so now I'm adding it late in the cooking process. So after adding my corn, I'm gonna tie it all together with my spinach and I'm gonna turn my stove off, okay, because I don't want to overcook my spinach and then end up killing all the fancy nutrients in the spinach, okay? You don't want to do that. So guys, my food is done. It is done, okay? I cannot wait to dig into this one because it smells so amazing and the taste, oh my god, it is that good. So now I've served it up and it's time to dig into it. So guys, you should try making this. It is so delicious and it's so healthy for you. Okay, so if you try making it, let me know in the comment section down below how it turned out. And if there's a way to make it better, let me know in the comment section down below as well. And I'll be glad to check it out and try your tips and your tricks that you share with me. Okay, I love you guys. Guys, if you haven't subscribed, now will be the time to do it. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button and share this video with your friends and your family, okay? I love you guys. See you all in the next video.